Good morning. How are you guys this morning? Are you excited for Christmas?
Yeah!
Now that, right there. That's that, right? If that doesn't pump you up, I don't know what will. Yay, I'm ready for Christmas too. Guess what? It's just next week. Oh, yeah. Okay, so, it's such a... Merry Christmas. A little early. Merry Christmas. It's going to be such a wonderful day. It really is. All kinds of special stuff today. We have all of our kids performing a song here soon. I know they're all super excited, and it's adorable. And then we have a couple. It's just going to be a great morning, you guys. But first, a few announcements. There are no Wednesday nights until January 5th. So just take this time, enjoy your family, the holidays. Spend a little extra time with God. You know, just dig into Him with your family over these next 2 weeks for sure. And then also, today, after the kids perform, if you're a child, you get to go back to your happy birthday Jesus party. That's pretty awesome. Yeah, I know. Happy birthday, Jesus, right? Yeah. Okay, so that is all I have announcement-wise. We are going to begin worship off this morning with offering, because offering is another form of worship, as the worship team is already up here. They're on it. All right, will you guys join with me in prayer? Dear Lord, thank you for this day, and just thank you for everything. Lord, as we give today, just bless this offering. Whether it's given here or online, wherever, Lord, you just bless it and multiply it. And Lord, as we move in to musical worship, just praising you, Lord, just have your way in our hearts and our minds fully today. Lord, we love you and we ask this in your name. Amen.
Amen. Stand if you'd like and let's sing Joy to the World.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. Joy to earth, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. No more listen. Sorrows grow, nor thorns infest the ground. He comes to make His blessings flow. Far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found. And He rules the world with truth and grace, makes the nations prove the glories of His righteousness, and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love, and wonders.
we'll give him all the glory.
We'll give you all.
You guys can find a seat real quick, and we're going to get things set up for the kids that are going to come up here. got to say is Brian's got to step his game up if we're going to follow that. We're going to get back into some worship here, so feel free to stand up, get comfortable. Let's worship the Lord this morning. Father, I just want to take a moment to thank you. Thank you for sending your son. Thank you for all that means. God, I thank you that my family's in church. I thank you for the rest of my church family, Lord. Lord, may you just bless them all. May you bless us. May we have an awesome day just remembering your glory this morning.
He became sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and he carried the cross. Love so amazing. Love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, name above. Amen. Sin was great, your love was greater, and what could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is, what a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ my King. What a wonderful name it is, oh, nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. And death could not hold you, the veil tore before you. Silence the boast of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory. For you are raised to life again. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of beautiful name it is. Well, nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. For you have no rival, and you have no equal. Now and forever, God, you reign. For yours is the kingdom, and yours is the glory. Yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is, and nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus.
What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, what a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is, nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. A powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. Powerful name it is, nothing can stand. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names.
We do that, Lord. We lift your name above all other names this morning. Just take a moment to do that. Just take a moment to lift his name. Thank you that nothing can stand against us, Jesus.
Oh, we praise you, Lord. Lift your name. We praise you. In the name of Jesus Christ, my
to be more in your presence, Lord Jesus.
I'm caught up in your presence, and I just want to sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never want to and I'm sorry when I've just gone through the motions. I'm sorry when I just sang another song. Take me back to where we started. I opened up my heart to you. And I'm
sorry when I've come with my agenda. I'm sorry when I forgot that you're enough. Take me back to where we started. I opened up my heart to you. I'm caught up in your presence, and I just want to sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never want to leave. No, I'm not here for blessings. Jesus, you don't owe me anything more than anything that you can do. I just want you. I just want you. Nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else. Nothing else, nothing else.
Can you commit that to the Lord this morning?
I just want you. Nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else. Nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you, and nothing else will do. No, nothing else will do. Nothing else will do. I just want you, and nothing else will do. No, nothing else will do. Nothing else will do. 'Cause I'm caught up in your presence, and I just want to sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I don't ever want to. And I'm not here for blessings. Oh, Jesus, you don't owe me anything. More than anything that you can do. I just want you. Oh, I'm not here for blessings. Jesus, you don't owe me anything. More than anything that you can do. I just want you. And more than anything that you can do, I just want you. Oh, more than anything that you can do, I just want to
sing it out to him, more than anything.
And more than anything that you can do, I just want more of you.
I've tried, but nothing else. Nothing else can take your place.
Nothing else. Nothing else will do.
We just want to make that commitment to you, Lord.
Nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing else will do.
More than anything. I just want you.
Lord, we thank you. Thank you, Lord, for giving yourself for us, for coming for us. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for your sacrifice. We thank you that you meet us where we're at, no matter what. Just thank you, Lord, for caring about us and loving us exactly where we are. Lord, as we move into service today, as we continue service today, Lord, have your way. Have your way in our hearts and our minds. Whatever it is that you want to speak to us, Lord, come in and invade this place. Invade every one of us, whether we're in this building or watching online, Lord, you have your way in us today. Have your way completely today, Lord Jesus. Lord, we love you, and we ask this in your mighty name. Amen. Worship together is so sweet. So sweet. We have get to hear from a couple different voices this morning, which is pretty exciting. First off, we have our youth pastor, Corey, going to share a little bit. And then we have our very own Megan, one of our youth students. She's going to share a little bit. And then I'll be back to close us out on this Christmas celebration day.
Well, Merry almost Christmas. I think we need to give another hand clap for the children's ministry because I saw a couple singers up here, and I know at their age, whenever I was their age, I'd have probably been either hunkered in the back or hiding behind somebody, maybe moving my mouth, but there was a couple of them. One of them was your daughter. She kept getting right up on that mic and singing, and I loved it. And the reason I love it is because I see future prospects. But, man, that warmed my heart to see these kids up here getting into it and loving it the entire time, because that's exactly what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to be up here with a joyful heart singing to the Lord. Amen? So I encourage you guys on your way out this morning to just encourage those kids, you know. Nothing tells you to do it more whenever somebody tells you what a great job you did. You know what I mean? So Debbie asked Megan and I a question, and it was, why Christmas? And I have my notes on my phone, so I'm not fancy enough to have an iPad yet. But as I was listening to that last song they did, they said there's a line at the beginning, and it says, "Take me back to the beginning." And that's exactly what Christmas is about. It's not about all these presents that we give everybody, although that's great and everything, and I'll talk about that here in a minute, but that's what Christmas is about. It's supposed to take us all the way back to the beginning when Jesus was born and the Word became flesh. Because that's the whole reason that we're all standing here in a church building praising God, is it not? So I think we need to sometimes reflect on the fact that we got to go back to the beginning. The Bible tells us to remember our God of old. That way we remember all of the things that He's done in our past, so we trust Him for our future. Does that make sense? Amen? That was just a little extra for you guys. How many of us have traditions that we've done since we were kids? This is participation time. We do things like making cookies on Christmas Eve, opening up one present on Christmas Eve, caroling, hanging certain ornaments, Christmas Eve vigil service, and so on and so forth. So I know for me, the thing that I always remember is one of my fondest memories is my dad would wake us up at somewhere between 5 to 6 a.m. And whenever I say would always, I mean I'm 30 now, and I got a phone call at like 5:45 or 6 o'clock last year, and hadn't lived with my dad for 7 years, and he still would call me and make sure I was up, even though we couldn't open up presents until my niece got there at like 9 or 10, but he would make sure that I was up and was ready for Christmas. He had the most childlike heart I've ever seen in a grown man in my life. He would prefer watching Flintstones and Charlie Brown and stuff like that over watching any other show, and that's what we would do 9 times out of 10 when I was a kid. We'd sit there and watch cartoons. And I think that was just so that he didn't feel like a weirdo for sitting there watching cartoons, because that's what I do now. I'll make my daughter sit on my lap and watch cartoons, and then when Cameron comes in and tells me to watch something else, I'm like, she really likes this episode. So. So through that, I realized that my why for Christmas was that he could have received zero physical presents for himself and been perfectly content. His favorite present was sitting there watching all of us kids open up presents. And then you take that back and you see exactly what happened for us is that, is it not? Because our Abba Father sent to us His one and only Son as a free gift to be saved from our sins. So He sent a gift to us just to watch the smiles on our face. He didn't send us a gift for us to then give Him gifts. He sent us a gift so we didn't have to sit there and burn incense and all these other gifts anymore. Amen? So He literally sent us a gift that was almighty to where we wouldn't even have to give Him gifts anymore. His gift from us is simply coming in with a joyful heart. So His gift from us is simply us coming in with a smile, or us singing and doing things that we love with a smile and doing it in His honor. Does that make sense? So Christmas is a beautiful reminder of what the gospel has shown us. So we're supposed to be in community. Christmas means spending time with friends and loved ones. We're supposed to show the love of Christ, and we're supposed to give with the heart of Christ. So Zephaniah 3:17 says, "The Lord your God is in your midst. A mighty one who will save, He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you by His love, and He will exalt over you with a loud singing." So my favorite line out of that is, "He rejoices over you with gladness," because that is an extremely beautiful picture, because that's exactly what I've been talking about. We come in with a happy face, coming up here doing things for the Lord, and He rejoices over us with gladness. He gives all of these gifts back to us again by giving us His presence like He did this morning, just because we came in with a glad heart. That's not us buying anything for Him. That's not us going out and building anything. His favorite thing for us to do is simply come in with a joyful heart so that He can use us. Amen? So before I pass this over to Megan, I would just like to take a time to talk about my youth group. these kids have warmed my heart this year. They're probably one of the best presents I've had, aside from my daughter. Sorry, she has to go first. But they've made my job so easy, and I use the term job very lightly, because it's something that I love to do. And if it's something that you love to do, I don't consider it a job. These kids have, Keely keeps sticking her tongue out at me. These kids have been a bright spot in my low days. They make me smile, they make me laugh. As you can tell, they shaved my beard and they thought it was just gonna ruin me. But then I saw myself in the mirror and I said, you know, I really don't hate it. But now whenever I walk out and it's cold, I really hate it because my face is extremely cold. But I've seen these kids start stepping out in faith, and we're gonna hear from one of the quietest kids that started out in my youth group. I just trying to get her to talk to me was like pulling teeth, but she showed up 1 week and then just never left. So I consider these kids my kids just as much as they're your kids, because I mean, I love them as much as sappy as that sounds, I do. So with that, I'm gonna pass the mic over to Miss Megan.
Okay, so when she asked us why Christmas, I actually never thought of anything for a while. So my stepdad was kind of like helping me plan ideas, and we came up with the wise men. So how they would have to go so far just to speak to him, or just to see him when he was born. So have any of, like, probably all of you guys have lost track of your faith at some point, so. And when that happens, we pretty much think, or we can lose sight of that walk with him that we have. So, but we can easily talk to him whenever and wherever we are. And we have full access of talking to him and talking about him. So, in these thoughts, I found my why Christmas. So we can easily have a relationship with Jesus and talk to him in front of even in the comfort of our own homes. When he was born in a manger in Bethlehem, there were people that came long distances just to see him and speak to him, one word to him. They right away came to honor him, not caring what anybody else would think or would like think of him. They followed the star, not knowing how long or how far it would be until they got to see him, but they still went anyways. So in Matthew 2:8-11, it says, "He sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search carefully for the child. When you found him, report back to me so that I too may go and honor him.' When they heard the king, they went ahead of them and stood over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother. Falling to their knees, they honored him. They opened the treasure chest and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. So they went out of their way just to go see him, and then they gave him gifts." So, and Jesus wants to have this relationship with us where we talk to him whenever and wherever we are, and basically just talk to him every moment. So since he died on the cross for us, we can do this. So this is my why Christmas, because he gave us this chance to have this access with him and speak to him whenever and wherever since he died on the cross. Okay, I'll hand it over to Debbie.
It's a good word. We don't have to travel miles and miles and miles to talk to Jesus. We do it wherever we want. That is a good word. Man, how do I follow that? Lord help me. So, wow. Why Christmas? You know, it is truly a wonderful reminder of the ultimate gift that we were given. Jesus Christ, he is the ultimate gift. You know, and we should be thankful for that. And why? Because He was born to fulfill the ultimate sacrifice. He was born to fulfill the law. What does that mean? You know, why do we need a sacrifice? In the Old Testament, we see three types of law. There's ceremonial law, civil law, and moral law. Ceremonial law was the law that had to do with worship, such as being clean from sin, and like Corey had mentioned, sacrificing animals and all of that. That was for us to do so that we could be forgiven. And we see, if you want to read about it, it's in Leviticus. There's all kinds of rules and laws there. But when Jesus came, he lived a life without sin. And we see this through scripture in the New Testament. And when he went to the cross, his blood was shed for us. And that is the ultimate sacrifice. He died for you and for me. And with Jesus being the sacrifice, it fulfilled the ceremonial law that the Old Testament writes about. Romans 10:4. For Christ has already accomplished the purpose for which the law was given. As a result, all who believe in him are made right with God. So that we no longer have to sacrifice animals and burn incense and go through all these rules and regulations. Because Jesus was born and came for us and was sacrificed. Isaiah 9:6. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. The government will rest on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. He came to earth fully human and fully God. And that's hard for us to wrap our minds around. It really is. But man, it was so that we could be washed clean from our sin and set free. Romans 3:25. For God presented Jesus as the sacrifice for sin. People are made right with God when they believe that Jesus sacrificed his life, shedding his blood. This sacrifice shows that God was being fair when he held back and did not punish those who sinned in times past. Man, right there. We were loved so much, we were given the ultimate gift so that we could be set free, so chains could be broken, so that we could have hope, so that healing could take place, so that we can invite him in as our Lord and Savior and be made new in him. Romans 3:22. We are made right with God by placing our faith in Jesus Christ. And this is true for everyone who believes, no matter who we are. The last part of that. And this is true for everyone who believes, no matter who we are. The ceremonial law is gone. The moral law still stands. But how amazing is it that the ultimate present of salvation, of eternal life, of hope, of joy, and love from an amazing Savior is ours. Every one of us on the face of this earth, it was a gift for us. Out of love. So no matter our past, no matter the mistakes we've made, no matter when we came to Jesus, you know, however long it's been, this is still good. This should still warm our hearts. It doesn't matter if we've been saved for 100 years or 10 minutes. This is what we have to remind ourselves. We've been given the ultimate gift. Romans 3:23. For everyone has sinned, we all fall short of God's glorious standard. Right there. Scripture knows, God knows, we've all sinned. We all fall short. But Jesus loves us anyways. He loves us no matter what. And he wants us to come to him. And Christmas is a beautiful reminder of the ultimate gift. A gift that cares for us so deeply that he died for us. As we celebrate Christmas this year, as we celebrate Christmas every day, but in this special season set apart, let us have a thankful heart and a tender joy no matter what the circumstances are around us. Because he cares for each of us and where we're at. The holiday holidays are harder for some than others. Some of us have lost people we love. Some of us have gone through some major hurt. Some of us are struggling with illnesses. Some just trying to find their way. But there's still a tender joy in Jesus Christ when he's our Lord and Savior that pulls us through. It's a beautiful, warming hope that we're going to walk through whatever it is. And just to find thankfulness in him, it's amazing that we've been given that gift. So if you're here and you haven't asked Jesus into your heart, but you would like to, and you want to accept that ultimate gift as your Lord and Savior, for no matter where you're at, no matter what you've done, he's here. He's wherever you are. Romans 10:10, for it is by believing in your heart that you are made right with God, and it is by openly declaring your faith that you are saved. With every eye closed and head bowed. Right now, if that's you, if you've not accepted Christ into your life yet, but you want to declare openly that you believe in him, that he came and he died for your sins, I'd love to pray with you right now. Because there is a hope in Jesus Christ. There is a future that is amazing. There is a tender joy no matter what situation you walk through. If you would slip up your hand, I would love to pray with you. Thank you. For those that raise their hands, in your own words, ask Jesus into your life as your Lord and Savior. Ask for forgiveness. Ask him to come in and guide you. And just thank him for being the ultimate gift. With eyes still closed. If it's been a while and you once had a relationship with Christ, but you've drifted, you're not as close as you once were. But man, you miss him. You miss that closeness. You miss that walking hand in hand. You feel distant. And you just want to rekindle that. You just want to walk with him again. Or maybe you didn't walk close the first time. And you're like, I want it. I want this hope. I want this. I'd love to pray with you also. If you would slip up your hand. Thank you. For those that raised their hands, in your own words, ask for forgiveness and invite him back in to be the center of your life again, to guide you every step of the way. Lord, thank you. Thank you for every single person in this place today. As we rejoice in your coming and being born in a manger, we thank you, Lord. Lord, right now, you meet every person where they're at. Whether right now they're struggling, they're hurting, or they're just asking for guidance from you. Lord, you come in right now and you do a healing in their hearts. You rekindle the joy. Holy Spirit, come and light the fire again. As we remember you and the ultimate gift that you are, we thank you, Lord. We just pray over every person in here that wherever they're at, you completely meet them. You meet them because you know them better than anyone. And you have a hope and a joy that's like nothing else for them, Lord. Lord, we love you. We ask this in your mighty name. Amen. Also, if you don't have a Bible and you would like one, please take one out of the pew in front of you. But man, how great is it that we got the ultimate gift? Eternity. Eternity. And help to break the chains of sin around us. Help in this life that we need it, because this life is hard. We all face things, struggles, hurt, but man, we got Jesus. And he is wonderful. And he cares about you. So no matter how lonely you might feel or misguided, go to Jesus, because he will meet you. He will meet you every time. You guys, it's been an awesome day. Our kids, Corey, Megan, how amazing is it just to see the next generations praising God and honoring him and speaking his word? It's so good. You guys have a very Merry Christmas. I love you all. Eat lots of whatever you're going to eat. But also, remember to thank Jesus. Remember to thank him in the midst of all of it. And go stuff yourselves with pie. Have a great week. Love you guys.